this sense of I'm not able to do enough, I'm not able to do the right thing, it has just become intense. And you know, they have watched and been with people who died of COVID pneumonia, and you know, they have experienced just up close this extreme version of physical suffering and then mental suffering, because they are there instead of the patient's families or instead of the people that that patient loves. Nurses right now and doctors are leaving the field in droves. I mean, we're on our way to a public health crisis because providers are leaving. We need to think of something, right? The reason I think psilocybin and psilocybin-assisted psychotherapy could be something really valuable there is that I think this kind of mental health treatment is really a new way of thinking how to address a mental health problem. There are a whole bunch of recent studies that show that using psilocybin in conjunction with psychotherapy can have tremendous benefits for people with depression, with anxiety, with cancer-related existential distress, and a host of other conditions. With this trial, I'm expecting to learn much more about psilocybin and how it works with psychotherapy for conditions that involve symptoms of depression, symptoms of burnout. My ultimate hope is that if these medicines are proven to be as valuable as they seem like now in this early phase, that there would be a way for a person who is suffering with depression or burnout or anxiety in the future could go to a qualified doctor or therapist or center and have a experience with psilocybin and psychotherapy that was completely safe, completely legal, well-regulated, and known to be beneficial. We're at the beginning of a new era, I think, in mental health care, and I think psilocybin is going to be one of the key ingredients in that.